Welcome again. We'll be covering the second part of paper 2. Now, the very first question talks about the crop combination models. There have been various models given by various scholars, and this model was propounded by Weaver. His idea for crop combination was based on standard deviation. The next question talks about cotton textile industry. Now, cotton textile is a unique industry because in cotton textile, the weight of the raw material and the finished product remains the same, more or less the same, and therefore it's considered a pure material. Now, this question is directly from NCERT. So, if you have thoroughly covered your NCERT 11th and 12th, these kinds of questions should not be a problem for you. So, the correct answer here would be 3. Now, the next question talks about the various sectors of economy. You have the primary sector, tertiary sector and the secondary sector. Here we would be discussing about the secondary sector. Now, farmer and coal mixer are directly dealing with the product directly from the earth, and therefore they are dealing with the primary sector of the economy. School teacher deals with the tertiary sector of the economy, and carpenter, which is dependent on the primary produce, that is wood, and is now manufacturing furniture or whatever, is basically a secondary sector that he is involved in. So the carpenter would be the correct answer here. Now, next question talks about the intensive subsistence rice cultivation. Rice cultivation has been a major focus mainly in the coastal areas, we know that. The next is, we are talking about intensive and subsistence. Subsistence means the thing that we are doing for ourselves, we are not trying to produce extra for the purpose of export. And intensive means where you have high density of population that is residing into that area. And as a result, what happens is you have manual methods of cropping that are used rather than factory farming that is used in extensive cultivation. So you have intensive subsistence rice cultivation in the areas of Southeast Asia, you have South China, Japan and coastal areas of India. The only exception is the Nile Valley, and the lower areas of Nile Valley you would find rice cultivation. More or less you have cotton cultivation that is seen in Egypt and the Nile Valley. The next question talks about the correct definition for gold collar workers. Now, this is the second question on the sectors of economy. Gold collar workers are basically the people who are involved in quinary activities, and those are the chief executive officers and the top management executives. So, 3 is the correct choice here. Now, next question talks about the concept of Lebensraum. Lebensraum concept was propounded by Redzel in his book Polish Geographic. So 2 is the correct answer. So you must know the name of the book to answer these kind of questions. Now, theory of heartland and rimland we have covered extensively in the videos. So you can refer that. Theory of heartland was given by Mackinder and Spikeman given by Rimland. Both of these theories are important, and off and on there is a question between these two. The next question is the cephalic index. Now, cephalic index deals with the index of head. So, B and C can be the only choice. First and fourth cannot be the correct answer. Now, it talks about the ratio of breadth to the length, and therefore we talk about dolichocephalic, which are long-headed people, and brachycephalic, which are broad-headed people. So, it's the correct ratio between breadth and length of the head. Now, next question is, which of the following statement is not true about state? There is a difference between state, nation and nation state. So we have covered that exclusively in the videos on political geography. Now, coming to the question here, we are asked about state and which is not a characteristic of state. So state means you have full sovereignty. So you have internal sovereignty and external sovereignty. So both of these are correct, and it has a territorial base, but it does not have a social and a cultural base, which basically forms a part of nation. So one would be the answer here. Now, next question, who coined the term geopolitics? A very direct question, off and on it's asked in 2012-13. Again, there were similar kind of questions. So this term was coined by Jelen. 3 is the correct answer here. Next question, a very interesting question. This talks about the integrated plan approach and the integrated rural development plan, which talked about the forward and the backward linkages, was propounded by Dantwala, and this was later modified by Chang, and you have numerous research literatures that can be found on this. This is exclusively from the section of regional planning. So regional planning, off and on you have questions where you have statements and phrases that are given, and who propounded those statements or who laid down those ideas are the types of questions that are asked from this. Now, the next question is, Which region does not constitute the Damodar River Valley region? Now, the Damodar catchment area includes the major parts of Jharkhand and West Bengal. So, you have Deltic Plains of West Bengal, Chotanagpur Plateau and Palmau Plateau, which are part of the Damodar Valley region. However, the plains of the Padma River does not form the part of the Damodar Valley part. So, you have two as the correct answer here. Now again, you have to match the size of the map with the type of the map that you can represent. Now cadastral is basically a very large scale map. So let's say I represent it by 1:50. This can be 1:500. This can be 1:5,000. And this can be 1:50,000. So this is just an assumption that I am trying to take. But a small scale basically represents. So whole of the India could be represented on a sheet of the paper. And that is what we mean by a small scale map. Now this small scale map is depicting the state. You have medium maps, medium scale maps, those depict the district. Large scale depict the block. And finally, you have the cadastral map that depicts the panchayat. Again, a very direct question from the NCERT itself. So, you have 4 as the correct choice here. So, you have state that goes with small and so on that we have matched up. So, you have this as the answer. Now, next question is, regional planning is the process of formulating and classifying social objectives in the ordering of the activities in supra-urban space. Very, very important question. Supra-urban space, the concept itself was given by Friedman, and Friedman did a lot of work on the supra-urban spaces. So the correct answer here is Friedman. Now next question. Bunch gave the exploitative model of the urban structure and he divided the state into 3 parts, the city of death, the city of need and the city of superfluity. He did not talk about the central business district. So, central business district is the answer here. Next question, National Highway 48. Very, very important. You have a new numbering for the national highways that has been given. And under the new numbering, what has happened is the National Highway 8 has now become National Highway 48. And north to south, you have even numbers. East to west, you have odd numbers highways now. So 48 is the highway that basically runs Delhi-Bombay and south further. So you have Pune, Surat and Ahmedabad that would lie on National Highway 48. A recent question, therefore it's important. So if you have been in touch with the news, this is something that you can easily solve. The next is, maximum teak forests are found in the region of Madhya Pradesh. Now in the map you can see you have the density of the teak forest that is given in India, and you can see the maximum teak forests are concentrated in the areas of Madhya Pradesh. So highest number of teak forests in India found in Madhya Pradesh. Now you have, which of the following passes connect Arunachal Pradesh and Tibet? Now you have a direct question which talks about the various passes. The correct answer here is Bomdila Pass. In the book on the maps, we have covered an exclusive list of the various passes and which connects India with the neighboring countries. Very, very important. You have to just memorize it and that's all. The next is, again, a question on census. There have been 2 to 3 questions every time on census that are asked. So this time you had the question on decadal growth rate. Decadal growth rate has declined from 91-2001 to 2001-2011, and the current decadal growth rate for 2001 to 2011 has been 17.64%. So 2 is the correct answer here. Now next question is, you have the assertion and the reason statement that has been given. The assertion is correct because the population growth rate has been high for Bihar as compared to Uttar Pradesh. We can see in the map below as we'll move down. So this is correct statement. However, growth rate does not simply talk about the natural increase. It talks about natural increase along with the migration. It can be in migration and out migration. So in migration and emigration, both would be the case, and it would include both of those. So reason is incorrect and assertion is correct for this question. Now next question. So here you can see the growth rate and you can see Bihar has nearly 25.1% of decadal growth rate as compared to Uttar Pradesh with 20%. So that was it. The next is the EMR band. Now EMR band, a very interesting way to remember is, you can remember the mnemonic Vibgyor. Now Vibgyor is the color of the rainbow starting from violet to red. Beyond red you have infrared. So R and R, you can remember it that way. And beyond violet, you have ultraviolet. So V and V, you can remember it that way. And the wavelength increases as you move here. So it would be wavelength that is increasing and frequency that would decrease. Now, since it's talking about the spectral band and you have the increasing order that you have to take out, so you would have ultraviolet, then you would have blue, green and red. So 2 would be the correct answer and this would be the increasing order. Again, I repeat, this is the increasing order for the wavelength and a decreasing order for the frequency. Next question, you have to match out the diagrams with the various aspects that they cover. Now, it's interesting to understand that dot maps are usually used to denote the population. So with one dot, I say one dot is equal to, let's say, 5,000 people. So if I need to depict a population of 50,000, what I need to do is simply place 10 dots and it's done. So that's the dot map to represent the population pattern. Then you use a star diagram to show the wind directions. It's generally used in the windrows. You have scatter diagram that talks about natural grouping. So what you do is you naturally put the scatters and the dots and you say that, okay, here the population of tiger is much higher as compared to this region, and that is a natural grouping that you are trying to denote with the scatter diagram. Isopleths, however, show a gradual change. So it was 10, 20, 30. So what it is showing is a gradual change over a space which is slowly and gradually moving on. The next question here is, which are the primary colors? We say RGB are the primary colors, that is red, green and blue, and the composition would lead to CMYY, that is cyan, magenta and yellow. So RGB are the primary colors. So you have red, green and blue as the correct answer here. Now next question, which of the following are line symbols? Isobars represent pressure, isochrones represent time, and contours and hatchures are used to represent the relief features. So the correct answer would be contours and hatchures, that is B and C. So you have B and C as the correct answer here. The last question, a very extreme peak of a normal distribution is known as. So you have a normal distribution curve and then you would have the extreme normal distribution curve. So this extreme, when the peak is extreme, it is known as leptocrutic. When it is flatter, it is known as pletichrotic, and when it is in between the two, we call it as mesocrotic. So this is a part of crotosis which is available again in the postal course material, the third part of the book. So you have these 50 questions that we have covered. We'll be covering paper 3 in the upcoming classes. If you have any doubts or clarifications, do leave those as comment below the video. Do join with us. Do subscribe so that you are engaged with the future videos that come up in geography. Have a very good day ahead.